called Just Press Live, and we're live! Before you do that, there are so many other things that you have to pay attention to before you can go live on Facebook using the tools that are already built into the platform. I have spent over 500 hours live on Facebook, and through all of that, trust me, there have been plenty of stumbling blocks, and we're gonna take those lessons learned, that way you can be successful with live video. Now, this is gonna be a very long video, but it's going to walk you through every single step to help you succeed. And be sure to stick around, because I'm gonna show you how to get rid of this frustrating quirk that Facebook always does as soon as your live video ends. Before you even go live, you wanna make sure that all of your technology is working and fully functional, because the last thing that you wanna do is plan this big, huge event and realize, oh, I can't even go live. So here's the thing, Facebook Live Producer only works in select browsers. I actually recommend using Firefox or Chrome. You wanna minimize as many distractions as possible. That means closing tabs that you don't need and disconnecting any apps that might be trying to use the internet. That means your Google Drive, your Dropbox, any of that stuff. Go ahead and mute those notifications, that way you can focus on your show. One mistake that beginner live streamers tend to make is that they don't check their internet upload speed, and it's super important. To have a successful broadcast, you need to have at least 5 megabits per second upload speed. So in order to do that, go to speedtest.net to check out what your internet upload speed is. And it's always a good idea to be hardwired. So you're probably wondering, well, how do I even start live streaming? You could get there a number of ways. The first way is through your Facebook business page. Other ways that you can access Facebook Live Producer, just go to facebook.com/live/producer. So if we take a look here on your Facebook business page, it's right there. You're just gonna push that live button, and that will automatically take you to the Facebook Live Producer. Now, this is Facebook's built-in live streaming studio. We're looking at the Go Live now, and that gives you an opportunity to start live streaming. But before you do that, we have to cover the basics. You'll see that you'll be going live on your business page, but if you wanna go live on your personal profile or to your Facebook group, from the drop-down menu, you can choose your personal profile or the group. Now, there is a caveat. If you were to go live in your group, there are some functionalities, some features that you wouldn't find if you were to go live on your business page, such as trimming your live video. And the first thing that you wanna do is give your video a title, because if people don't know what your show is about, why would they even want to tune in? So think about what your headline is going to be to capture that attention. Next, you want to put in your description. Descriptions are important. You're competing with all of the other content that's in the newsfeed. And if people don't know what your show is about, why would they even tune in? Make this the best part of your live stream. And you can even add a couple of cool things. For example, you could check in, let them know where you're gonna be live streaming from. Is it from some exotic place? Some fun conference like Social Media Marketing World? Next, you can go ahead and put your feeling/activity. I like to tell people if I'm super excited, if I'm happy. It just gives that extra flair of excitement about you broadcasting to your audience. That way they have access to you. If you are raising money for your organization, give people that opportunity to participate and donate to your cause. And the next part is tagging a sponsor, a brand that you're working with. Next, you'll see the section for gaming. If you're not gaming, completely skip that. You don't need to pay attention to that. And then the next part is gonna be your video thumbnail image. This is fun if you already have an image that you want to use. It should be 1200 by 675, but if you don't, then stick around, because I'm gonna tell you how you can fix this after your broadcast. Now, this is a feature that not that many people know about, and it's called the cross-posting functionality. You can go live on your page and another brand's page. Simply click on this button and you can see all of the different pages that you could go live to simultaneously at no extra cost. Now, when it comes to cross-posting, there are additional steps to be mindful of. You could actually learn more about that in this video. Here's a feature that you'll like if you're an admin of a Facebook group. You can choose which groups you want to go live to. That means you could go live on your page and have your broadcast automatically shared to your Facebook groups. One thing to note about both of those features is that if you cross-post your broadcast and if you share it to a group, the comments from your viewers in those destinations actually won't appear on your main business page. So be mindful of that. And if you're interested in growing your Facebook group, you'll definitely love this feature. You can choose which group you want to promote as a call to action. That way, when you are live streaming, Facebook will automatically promote that group. Now let's get into audience settings. Basically what that means is that if you wanted to limit the reach of your broadcast, you can tell Facebook, well, I only want people at a certain age range to watch my video. If you wanted to go live in specific locations, geographic cities, things of that sort, you can restrict your reach as well. But from a live streaming perspective, you want to get in front of as many audiences as possible. So if anything, I would skip that. When it comes to live streaming, it's always good to test. And that's the advantage of this checkbox. Once you check it off, you'll have a test broadcast that no one else can see, just you. So that way you can make sure that your audio and your video is working perfectly. Now let's move on to the stream setup. This is where you're going to find your direct link to any of your Facebook Live broadcasts. That means if you need to promote your show, this is the link that Facebook provides you. It's going to be facebook.com/live. Now you have three options. The first one is to use a stream key, which actually requires you to use a third-party platform, so forget about that. The second option is using your camera, and that could be your built-in camera or an external camera like a webcam or even a DSLR, which I like to use. And the third option is using a paired encoder, and again, that's another third-party tool which we'll forget for now. When it comes to the setup options, I always select persistent stream key. There's no reason for me to change that at all. The second one is also use a backup stream. I don't need that because I know that Facebook will always have a recording for me that I could download in the future. If you have a really bad internet connection, I would say don't live stream, but sometimes you might have to. Go into the stream settings and uncheck this box. And the reason for that is if you have poor internet connectivity issues, Facebook will kick you off right then and there and end your broadcast. If you don't want that to happen, uncheck this box right here. If you want people to join your live broadcast outside of Facebook, it's really easy to do. You go into the settings and copy and paste the embed code to share on your website. Even if they can't watch live, they could still watch the replay. Here's another feature that you can take advantage of, and it's unpublishing your video as soon as your live broadcast ends. Now that's something that you want to do if you want to create that FOMO effect, that fear of missing out. Whenever I'm live streaming, I tend to leave that unchecked because I do want people to tune into the replay. Here's a feature that not that many people know about, and it's giving your viewers the option to rewind the live video broadcast as you're live streaming. This is a great way to give your viewers a chance to catch up to what you're sharing online. To activate this, click on the drop-down menu for viewing and make sure to check off the box that says allow viewers to rewind. This next setting can be really helpful, and it's letting Facebook auto-generate captions. Now this is nice if you have a speaker that can enunciate really well, because Facebook's artificial intelligence will be able to give you that transcript. However, if you are in a noisy environment, you might want to have that unchecked because you never know what the AI is going to say. This next setting allows you to make changes to how comments appear in your live broadcast. I really don't use any of these. However, if your brand page tends to get a lot of trolls, then this is something that you'll want to pay attention to. So the first one is called followers. Only followers of your brand page are allowed to comment. The next setting slows down comments. That means when viewers are watching, they can only comment every 10 seconds. The discussion setting is really interesting. That would limit your viewers from leaving comments that were less than 100 characters. Now, this is cool if you want to have a more engaging conversation, but if someone just wants to say, "Hi, tuning in from San Diego," that comment won't even appear on the screen. Now, these last two settings are really to help you deter any spammers or trolls from commenting on your broadcast. The first one is restricted. Any Facebook user that has a Facebook account that's less than 2 weeks old, they won't be able to comment on your broadcast. Second is protected. Commenters must have followed your page for at least 15 minutes. If they haven't followed your page, they won't be able to leave a comment. The next tab over is your stream health. And this is really helpful for you to know how your broadcast is performing as far as video and audio bitrate. Now, if you really want to drive engagement for your show, then having polls is really fun to do. In this tab, you'll type a question and include the answers that you want your viewers to vote on. For instance, have you learned something new from today's video? So once you've created your poll and you've saved it, you can select when you want your poll to appear for your viewers. Another way to engage your audience is to post a question. You could say, "What else would you like to know?" And that question will pop up and your viewers can leave their answers in the comment. Now let's talk about how to set up your built-in webcam so that way you can start live streaming. Sometimes when you're connecting your built-in camera for the very first time, your browser may ask you for permission to give your browser access to your camera. Once you've had that all set set up, then you don't have to worry about that again. If you're using an external camera or microphone, you could choose your preferred device from these drop-down menus. In this case, I'm just gonna use the built-in camera. Here's something else that you'll notice here. There's a button that allows you to screen share. But here's the thing. If you choose screen share, you can't switch back to your camera. Either you're going live with your camera or you're going live to screen share. In this particular case, I'm using the built-in webcam and an external microphone. Here's something else that you want to remember is that when you go live, wear headphones. And the reason for that is because the audio that comes out from your desktop might feed into your microphone, and you don't want that. And now we're ready to go live. So let's go ahead and hit that button. And here I am. And I'm going to scroll up, and you could actually see it right here. There's my built-in camera. If you take a look here at the user interface, on the left-hand side, what you notice, you see the comments, and these are all of the viewers that we have here today. So Michelle, Irmer, Dean, it's so wonderful to have you here. If I scroll down on the middle of the user interface, this is where I could see the stream setup. Everything that we talked about earlier as far as settings, how to connect the camera, as well as your external microphone. Now this is the part that I had mentioned about stream health. This is where we can see the performance as far as video bitrate, frame rate, and audio bitrate. So far, we're doing pretty good. When you're ready to show your poll, you just push publish poll, and then it appears on the screen, just like this. Now, if you notice, people have already started to vote, and now I could show you the results in the video. At the very bottom, I could see the video results. It looks like the viewers aren't able to see it. Now let's talk about the question that I had showed you guys earlier. So the question is, what would you like to know about live video? I see the question that I publish on the upper right hand of the screen. So when you publish your question, your viewers might not see it right away. So give them a few seconds to catch up. Now this is a really cool feature. If I wanted to clip a short segment from this live broadcast, I could add a title to say test and then create new clip. Now I have a clip that I can share on social media to tease what this video is about. Now I'm going to show you how you could pin a comment. Take a look over here. Here's Irmer's question, and I just click on pin, and that will be the pin comment that shows at the very bottom of the live stream. One of the nice things about live streaming from your desktop is that you can actually reply to comments. So for Irmer, who is asking what software are you using, I can simply reply within the stream, Facebook Live Producer. And this is why it's super helpful to be prepared for your show. Because if there's a link that you want to promote, you want to have it already copied and pasted into your clipboard. To end your live broadcast, just go ahead and click on this big red button that says end live video. After you've clicked the red button to end your live video, it doesn't stop there. There's always going to be a delay. So hold that pose or smile just 3 seconds longer, and then the live video will end. Once your live video has ended, you can rate how the live stream went and give Facebook feedback. And then if you wanted to, you could delete the live stream right then and there, or you could view the post to make the edits that you need to optimize your video. So as promised, I'm going to show you how to get rid of that frustrating quirk that Facebook always does whenever it's picking your thumbnail image. All right, so we go over to the three dots and then click on see more options, edit post. Then you're gonna see the thumbnail. This is your opportunity to choose which thumbnail you like best. So once you click on edit post, Facebook will show you its auto-generated thumbnails that you can choose from. However, Facebook sometimes chooses the most embarrassing image, even in the auto-generated frames. So what I like to do is I like to take my phone and I like to take a selfie. And then I use that image as the thumbnail image for the video. Now, when it comes to live streaming, it's not just about the setup and the gear. It's how to get the gears working up here. How do you create a successful live stream that absolutely captivates an audience? Click here to view our playlist that teaches you everything that you need to know in order to be successful with live video. And I'll see you there.